How you doing, Trench?
I'm back.
Now, in this part three of our series of refuting, debunking Zakir Hussain, the teacher of Farid response, we're going to continue the spanking of Zakir Hussain, exposing him for the liar and deceiver that he is. He is one of the most well-known Muslim apologists of today, and he is the teacher of these liars and deceivers who call themselves Muslim apologists.
My name is Zakir Hussain. I'm a Muslim apologist based in the UK, and I try to specialize mainly with Judaism and Christianity because I believe we have a lot in common. Now, when was this claim made that the Prophet Muhammad on whom be peace was foretold in the previous books? Is it a modern day thing that Muslims have just made up to try to make our faith look more credible? No. This goes back 1400 years to the very time that the Prophet Muhammad on whom be peace set foot into a city called Medina where the Jews were awaiting a prophet to come. And in the next verse it says, and he shall come with 10,000 companions and a fiery law in his right hand. Now who came with 10,000 companions and a fiery law in his right hand? That was Prophet Muhammad on whom be peace, which once again shows that the brethren that he was speaking about were the Ishmaelites.
Guys, I want to know, is this guy stupid or what?
Well, what's the matter? Is he stupid?
Did you see what just happened, guys? Did you notice what happened? How convenient that suddenly, while he is mentioning the verse from chapter 33, verse 2, in the background we can read, technical issues occurred. Video will be back soon. He is doing this on purpose so that his Muslim audience are not noticing something. What did he do? If you know your Bible well, Christians, you will know that's not the entire verse. He deliberately removed the first part of the verse to make it sound as if it is talking about Muhammad. Where is the first part of the verse? Almost the half of the verse is missing, or maybe more than half. Where is the rest of the verse? Where is the first part of the verse? You liar, you deceiver. Zakir Hussain, you have no honor, you have no shame, you have no dignity. انت ما عندك شرف. يا مسكين, يا زكر حسين, انت ما عندك شرف. يا جبان, يا كذاب ابن كذاب. يا مسكين, يا منافق. Go smooch that black stone, you liar. You have no shame, you have no honor, you have no dignity, Zakir Hussain. Playing with our Holy Bible. So, you Muslims are the ones who are playing with our Bible. You are the ones who are corrupting our Bible with your own hands. Shame on you. But we know you Muslim apologists today don't have any honor or any dignity. انت ما عندك شرف يا كذاب ابن كذاب يا زكر حسين يا مسكين. Now let us see how the true verse reads. The true form of the verse, not his lies on the screen that you see here. Omitting the first part, more than half of the part, the first part of the video. Now let us go to the verse and read it and expose this liar and deceiver who has no honor or any shame. Now here is the real verse from Deuteronomy 33 verse 2 from the English translation called World English Bible. He said, Yahweh came from Sinai and rose from Seir to them. He shone from Mount Paran. He came from the 10,000s of holy ones. At his right hand was a fiery law for them. So he completely removed the first part that you see here to deceive his audience, right? To deceive his audience. Because if you are truly a sincere Muslim, or let alone a Christian, we Christians are going to bust you, as I'm doing right now, because you omitted the complete first half of the verse. It clearly saying that it's Jehovah, Yahweh himself, the Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He is the one who will come, not Muhammad. So do you see how he completely removed this highlighted first part to make it sound as if it is talking about a prophet? As if, between brackets, it's talking about Muhammad. You liar! Shame on you for playing with our Holy Bible. Shame on you. But we know you, Muslim apologist, you have no shame. And remember, Zakir Hussain is the teacher of Farid. Response, right? He is his teacher. They got their information from people like him. What an embarrassing lie. Shame on you. But we know you Muslims have no shame. Tfu alik, Muhammad Hijab would have said. Tfu alik. You son of Satan. You bastard of Satan. Shame on you. To make it even more clear, this is another translation for Deuteronomy 33 verse 2. The Living Bible translation. The Lord came to us at Mount Sinai and dawned upon us from Mount Seir. He shone from Mount Paran, surrounded by 10,000 of holy angels and with flaming fire at his right hand. So the Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he himself came from Mount Paran. He himself, God himself, with his holy angels. And it's not 10,000 of companions of Muhammad. It's 10,000 in the end. More than 10,000. Tens of 10,000s. Right? 10,000s. Many. More than 10,000s. Right? Maybe 100,000. Maybe even more. And those are the angels, not companions of Muhammad. Last time I checked, the companions of Muhammad, the Sahaba, are not angels in Islam, right, Zakir Hussain? You liar. You have no shame. You have no honor. You have no dignity. Shame on you. But you have no shame, right? You have no shame. Guys, now do you see how desperate people like Zakir Hussain, Muslim apologists, want to prove to us that Muhammad is their real God? They want to prove to us that Muhammad is the real God of Islam. This is why they want to commit blasphemy. This is why they want to commit shirk for the sake of Muhammad, calling him the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in Deuteronomy 33 verse 2. Why would you else call Muhammad Jehovah? Huh? The verse is clear. The verse is saying that it's Jehovah, the Lord himself, will come, not Muhammad. So do you see how they over and over and over want to show us that Muhammad is their real God, their true God of Islam? Do you see how they actually nothing but Muhammadans, worshippers of Muhammad? Why would you else then want to prove to us that Muhammad is the God of the Bible? What an embarrassing statement, Zakir Hussain. If they are true Muslims, sincere Muslims, you need to go to Zakir Hussain, grab him by his nasty beard, drag him over the floor, and force him to repent for his shirk, for his blasphemy, calling Muhammad the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, in Deuteronomy 33, verse 2.
And in the next verse, it says, and he shall come with 10,000 companions and a fiery law in his right hand. Now, who came with 10,000 companions and a fiery law in his right hand? That was Prophet Muhammad, on whom be peace.
What the hell is this? A'udhu billah. We have seen the evidence. You cannot escape anymore. You're finished. A'udhu billah. Everyone will unfollow you now. You are a crook. And you are a fraudster. And we will call each and every single one of you out. Wallahi, we'll call you out and we will catch you. Because part of our da'wah is not just to find the disbelievers. The disbelievers who are a'da', the enemy is disbelievers. But also to find the munafiqoon of the ummah. That they're creeping around pretending to be Muslims. You're finished. You're finished. You're finished. You're finished. Wallahi, you're finished. Wallahi, you're finished. Don't ever come out. Any retraction you do now, Switch off your social media. I don't want to see your face. I don't want to hear your voice. Wallahi. Wallahi, you're a crook and a fraudster.
What are you, stupid or what?
Ya Zakir Hussein, shame on you. Ya mushrik, son of a mushrik. You blasphemer, how dare you to call your prophet our holy God, the God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob of the Holy Bible. Muslims, when are you going to force him to repent? Please don't forget to share our videos all over social media. Let them go viral, people. Thanks for watching and God bless.
Maybe I'll fight Apollo, maybe I won't, you know? What do you think? Adrian!